for another episode, another segment of this episode of Saloon Talk Season 3. You are still watching it right here on ABBA TV. The show runs from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. every Sunday evening. We were still talking about the topic of DNA and its validity in the world, actually at large. I will not only like minimize it to a specific content, but my next question comes from a well-known perspective of this. Do you think women or men, like, who do you think are more inclined to DNA testing? Is it women or men?
Can I go first? Okay. I think both, and I will give you my reasons. First, men, I will not say they are more inclined, but they should be inclined. Okay, you sow this seed, but you can never be sure that you are the master of your garden. If you get what I mean.
Wait, I mean, for us who have not got what you mean.
If you're not sure of even the woman you're sleeping with, why don't even claim for the child?
Okay, there is assuming that everything is well.
Because you men assume
and
for
why,
women.
And why most men are facing it rough is because they move on context of assumptions.
And that's where you go
I'm not
wrong.
Saying she's not faithful. I'm not saying she's cheating on you. Uh-huh. And I will go back to my first statement that there is no wrong in being sure.
Then you're having a child with a person that you know does not deserve.
Not really, Carol. We are human beings. You can never know at which point your spouse had to loosen up a bit.
Why would they loosen up? Are you not man enough?
Very many factors that are well known. That are well known to them.
Men offer everything that a woman wants, then you have comfort.
That
means
it comes in variations.
You are not being a man to start doubting that child.
Carol,
that is in someone.
When you say that men offer everything a woman needs, I'll object to that because it comes in variations. I could give you enough money, but I may not be able to give you enough sex.
It's not about money. I'm always on the set here.
Yes.
I always tell men, relationship, marriage is not about money. It's about first friendship.
Yes, and I was just giving an example using money. But everything in a relationship comes in variations. I could be a good lover, but not a good friend. Do you believe?
You didn't find your soulmate.
Carol, what do you mean soulmate? Who is a soulmate?
Hold on.
A soulmate. It all depends on us being human beings, and no person is perfect. Considering those two factors, Banange, being sure is okay, Carol. Going to my next point before Carol bombards me with another.
Let me first of all try to say this to you guys.
Okay.
Listen, when you're talking about this DNA situation, it all comes with passion. It comes with love. When you're having
and
children, it's about
and
love,
the trust of someone.
Because
yeah.
when you're making that baby, the angels that are seated right next to you, according to the Bible.
Sounds
you
good.
Understand?
Yeah.
But the thing is,
babies.
When you are actually, you can even sense when you're going to have a child, by the way, if you didn't know that. For you to throw out tantrum that your wife is cheating, it means that you are cheating yourself.
Carol, let me ask you a question.
Let me first tell you something. You men should stop throwing bombs at women about the DNA test.
And that's why I need to advise men out there.
And that is why I needed a glass of wine on this
set.
Let me advise the man out there. Do you hear how Carol is saying it? Please, if you have to do a DNA test for your kids, don't let her know. Just take your kids, know their DNA, and you'll be well in your home. Because now, from her school of thought, she's making it sound evil for me to go and test my kids. I just want to know that they're mine. There's no problem in that.
You are testing these kids.
Going to my next point.
Then secondly, also women. I'm going to say this.
Carol, before you tell us about the women, I was going to tell you why women also need to do their DNA test for their children. Do you believe some women, let me talk about the promiscuous women, women who indulge in more than one relationship can fail to tell who the father of their kid is.
That's true.
True, yeah. Very true.
So, women, also check your kids for DNA so that you can ascertain who the fathers are.
Thank you.
Another point could be...
But that woman out there that does not know the father of their kids would need serious whooping.
These things are in society.
How would you not know the father of your child?
Like I said to you, these things happen because you've not married your friend, your soulmate. That's why you see we have all these questions around. But if there's a relationship that is, you're bonded by Christ, you understand? I'm not saying that I'm a super perfect woman. I've had my scandals.
Of course,
I'm not
saying anything. Yeah.
Everyone knows. But the thing is, like, you when you're sure you want to have a child, stick to one man, one person.
You see, Carol, a relationship, I would say it is a two-way because it involves two people.
Yes.
Now, hail Carol. I'm calling you Hail Carol from Hail Mary because you sound
no,
so.
No, I am not.
Okay.
Not, and I'll never.
Much as Carol, you could be perfect to your partner.
I am not perfect to my partner.
No, how you are sounding.
And he's not perfect.
How you are sounding is one or two women can be like how you're saying, but you can never be sure of how your spouse is. And now this I'm talking about is from a man's perspective.
I understand.
Yeah, I could be your friend. You're a very good friend. But I don't know whether you're paying me back with the same. Action-wise, you could be paying back the same. But I don't know what happens behind my back when you're in my absence.
But why have all those questions in the first place?
I know. That's really
it is
a question.
Safe. It is safe to have questions.
Love is blind.
Karen's going to lie to us. Please. Karen's going to lie to us.
No. She is right.
To lie to us.
She is right. Hear me out. She is right, but 50% right. Because the 50%, the other 50%, love is blind, but there are some things that you cannot be blind to. You see them, but you choose to be blind. So it may be blind, but...
Please, if that love has to be blind, let it be blind at the first encounter.
Not at the end.
For the men, let it be blind because maybe you're colorblind and you've seen a brown Savaria. Let the blindness end at that. Moving forward, please, don't be blind. Yes, open your eyes wide and see.
Okay, guys, we let us continue with the questions. Come on, we have reached the conversation down to the point that we are even
lost.
Yeah. Okay. So let me give you an example of a few people out there. It is very, to me, I say it is very important in certain circumstances to do DNA testing. Yeah. For example, we have had most cases of people that are famous. For example, Muchiri, the one who owned St. Lawrence, may he rest in peace. When he died, he had a number of children who came up because of his death. Why? Because now he has died, his empire has to be taken over by his children, by his people. So now, my question comes from this, why is it that most people or most children that have not been a part of your life, they come onto the surface when you have passed away or when you have created, when you have made it in life? Why do you think that most children surface when either you've died or you've come about a very big amount of fortune? Why do you think so?
I think Carol, you first go.
Okay, like I said, first when I told you, when we were starting this conversation, this topic, I said that it's important or not important as such, given the circumstances. Because this is a bit diverse. It's about outside and inside. So I was looking at locked in marriage, in the marriage context. But now, right now, we're talking about the famous and then people coming with children and then what have you. Yeah. DNA is very important at the end of the day, if we're going to be honest to ourselves. Because if someone is walking in with children after my death, I don't think I'm going to allow that kid to come in without going for that DNA.
Why after
but
that you're, day?
But you're dead already. How are you going to...
Exactly. Well, of course, they still have the DNA from you. You can still connect
with
other kids. You understand? Mm. So people, most times, I have just lost my dad, I think, 6 weeks ago. And some people surface. And we told them, we don't know you.
People that don't, you didn't even
know. Yeah, we didn't know them. You understand? So we told them, if you want to claim for, we need to take you for a DNA to prove that you're our children. But for me, also men hide from us, especially the tycoons and everything and what have you. Sometimes you think people are coming for the wealth. Kume, this guy has been having kids outside
the marriage. He knew about them, but he just kept quiet.
Because I had a friend who was having a husband, and a man used to come back home at 5. But when this gentleman died, a wife suffers from somewhere with 3 kids, claiming to be the wife, and indeed he was. So in most cases, I think, overall, given the circumstances in Uganda, worldwide, DNA is very important because of bakazi.
I'm glad Carol is getting on my page.
Yeah, but I've been on your page, but you're not kind of getting me. So given that women also have become something else, because I know women don't want to work.
Yeah.
And they're targeting those men.
Very
you get
true.
A situation where this person did something in a hotel and everything, and making sure that they target those high profile men with kids. One night stand turned into a child. And this man must be in position to prove whether the child is his or not. So it's important. Then also when it comes to people targeting those high profile, because I've never seen someone go for poor families asking for DNA. So only those high profile families.
You guys go for high profile, by the way. Yeah.
So basically, I think it's DNA must be introduced as mandatory in Africa now, or Uganda, because things have become tough. We're not going to live in the old era, given the reasons as to the circumstances that we are living in, because we've become over greedy. We want so much for ourselves.
Okay, I think let me first catch you right there. We're gonna come right to you, Bruce. To your comment to this. Let us go for another commercial break. When we come back, we are still digging into the perspective of DNA testing. Is it funny or is it not? Do you think it's important or it's not? Let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, we're going to start with the male perspective of this.